You know the gasoline generator as the hero for all emergency situations. The problem is that it is noisy for all the time that you use the electricity. And also you know that 2/3 of the energy in the fuel is discarded as waste heat. We'll explore a surprising new way how to recover the heat of the engine. So let's stay outside now the heat in the exhaust gases. We did that already the last week, but now we are looking at all the hot parts of the engine, and that will give you an enormous increase of the system performance, because instead of only 3 kWh of electric energy, which is in the fuel, you get in addition 6 kWh of heat. So let's dive in. Hi, Norbert here. I'm an energy engineer. In this video number 79, I take our do-it-yourself CHP combined heat and power to the next level. After using the last week the exhaust gases for heat recovery, we will now address another equal part of heat, which is in the hot parts of the engine, so the cylinder and also the muffler, where the sound of the engine is reduced. And that brings us from the double performance to the triple performance, compared with the production of only electricity, which is the normal use of this generator. So this is a little bit of calculus. If you take 1 liter of gasoline, in Italy it's about 180. And now if you look to the price of electricity, so the all-in price that is calculated by just taking the bill of electricity, dividing by the consumption in that period, then you get more or less 60 cents. And if it's not today, it will be in a near future. Okay, so that means that for the price of 1 liter of gasoline, you can pay for 3 kWh of electrical energy from the grid. In a liter of gasoline, there's more or less 10 kilowatt hours of energy. 3 of those kilowatt hours are converted by a genset into electricity. So that means that 1 liter of fuel, more or less the same price as those 3 kWh purchased from the grid. Now, and then you have still those 6 kWh of heat, which are also in the same fuel that we are now going to recover. This heat is free and you can use it to heat your home. Heat recovery in traditional CHP, combined heat and power units, is traditionally done by circulating water through the engine. That is, of course, very effective, but it can be difficult, especially for a do-it-yourselfer, to modify an air-cooled generator with the water circulation around. You have to fix a tube, a metal tube, all around the cylinder, and that for several times. Maybe I will do it later. If I can find a way that is easy enough for you, do it yourself. But today, I want to introduce a complete other way that goes really around this challenge. Many heat pumps struggle with efficiency in very cold weather. Older models might even stop working, while the modern units have an automatic defrost cycle to deal with ice buildup. At minus 5 degrees Celsius, this defrosting cycle could be triggered every 30 to 90 minutes. That depends also on the humidity in the air. This all comes at the cost of efficiency. Now, what if you place the external unit not outside but inside, for example in a garage? That will, of course, increase, but very much increase, the temperature of around this external unit, and it will have an easy life, and therefore it will have a much better performance. So, for example, if you put outside this external unit and it is minus 5 degrees, then you might have a COP of 2.5. So 1 kilowatt in and 2.5 kilowatt out. But now you put it inside, and inside there might be a temperature of 10 degrees, 15 degrees, 20 or 25 degrees. Okay, what will happen? For example, at 20 degrees, you'll have a COP of 5. That means 1 kilowatt in electric and 5 kilowatts out of heat. That's double. Now then you will think, of course, this garage will quickly go down in temperature. Then we will end up, your car will end up like this car here in Siberia. Amazing, this video got 12 million of viewers. I don't wish you to tackle these kind of problems if your garage is becoming a deep freezer after some hours. So here comes the gasoline generator in play. Its waste heat will warm the air in the garage, compensating for the heat pump's cold air output. So you see, the generator and the heat pump, they like each other's company. And the result is that for each 1 kilowatt of input electrical power, the heat pump will give 5 kilowatts of heat output if the garage is at, for example, 20 degrees Celsius. Instead of only 2.5 kilowatts for the same kilowatt hour of electrical input, if the outside unit is outside at -5 degrees Celsius. And that is a massive difference of 2.5 kilowatts for the same 1 kilowatt of input power. Well, that becomes a no-brainer.
Oh, yeah.
In addition, it will avoid all the tinkering and all the modifications on the engine. And you can adopt a simple standard solution like this heat pump. And by the way, I bought a simple unit because in these conditions of higher outside temperature, you can buy also a simpler model which is not capable of working in harsh outside conditions because the conditions are not harsh anymore. So I paid for my unit 270 euros only. Of course, if the heat pump in these good conditions is able to move 5 kilowatts from the garage to the living room, then you must also be able to deliver this 5 kilowatts. Another way that you might think to recover this heat is just heat the air in the garage and then bring it through a tube to the living room. Well, that's a little bit of a problem because it's very diluted, this heat energy. Maybe it's only 25 degrees at the most. And well, then you need very big hoses, and maybe you should make a big hole between the garage and the living room, and that's not the very nice solution. Instead, this heat pump, because it's able to move
heat
from a lower temperature to a higher temperature, it's able to bring this heat from the garage to the living room through very thin pipes. And as you know, these split heat pumps, they are a standard, they are really a mainstream product, and therefore they can be quite cheap. Before revealing the big surprise that makes this solution so exciting, let me just tell you that we are not playing here around on this channel and losing time. No, where we are losing time, that's on this planet, by messing up with the nature, by consuming as if there were no tomorrow, and even with wars. Also, the last scientist is now convinced that time is up if we continue in this way. So let's show that we normal folks, we have the real sense of reality, not colored by special interests, other than delivering
a good planet
to the next generations and not only the human race. We households, we can make a difference. And if the market doesn't make what we need, well, then we just make it ourselves. In the past, I was convinced that everything we need, sooner or later, will be made by some smart entrepreneur that will produce that product, that service, in the millions. All the rest was for me nice and maybe relevant for a few people. Now that I research and experiment each week, I am realizing that there are technology that make nearly infinite combinations. Like if you have three digits, then you can make 1,000 numbers. I don't say now that with a generator, with a heat pump and with a battery, you can make 1,000 surprises. But I do believe that this solution of this video is very difficult to find on the market. And also that it can be useful for a lot of households. Look for a moment. On the one hand, you have all these generators, which are present in from 5 to 15% of the households in the developed countries. And from the other side, there are many households that have a heat pump, and in 10 years it will be much more, because also the government is pushing this technology. And many of those heat pumps have the external units in their cold outside. I think especially when society as a whole is changing and the market is slow to follow up with the correct technology. But okay, I get a little bit distracted. The only thing that I want to know if what you think about this solution, and also if you agree with me that it is incredible fun to be creative, to do it yourself. If you want, you can join the two Facebook groups in English and in Italian, and then we can continue the discussion on a bilateral way instead of a one-man show. On the other hand, if it's for you enough to learn about do-it-yourself innovation, saving money, contributing to the energy transition, but also to secure your energy supply, then like and subscribe to the channel and to stay updated every week and even more. And now the big surprise that I promised 3 minutes ago. You will absolutely love this solution after realizing how it benefits you. This secondary room, where you have the generator and also the heat pump, it acts as a thermal storage. Because when the battery is full, so you stop the generator, the heat pump can go on because of the residual heat in the secondary room. The more so, when the generator gives more heat than the heat pump takes away. Because in that case, the garage will heat up slowly during the time that this generator is running. For example, from 10 degrees to 25 degrees Celsius. And when the battery is full and the engine stops, then you first enjoy the silence. And in addition, you can consume all the heat that is stored in this secondary room or the garage, which is at 20 or 25 degrees. Maybe your car is there and its engine is still warm. So the temperature in the garage will go up and down, and you can determine which cycle times are the best for you. You can also put there a water tank of a cubic meter or so, and then that will absorb not only the heat and act also as a storage, but it will save you in the case of a blackout. If this blackout is also stopping
the pump,
which is taking this water to your house, or maybe even the central pumps of the water supply. And don't say that this won't happen, because I know places where this is business as usual in Europe. So thanks to this configuration and the increased COP of the heat pump, you will have, for nothing, completely free, you will have this additional heat in the example above 2.5 kilowatts that you can enjoy. And it is all in the same liter of gasoline. And of course, you will like to run it both together, because then the generator will also supply the power to the heat pump, so they will run together. So for example, if you have a gasoline generator with a power of 3 kilowatts and the heat pump takes only 1 kilowatt, then you have 2 kilowatts that you can put in a battery. This thermal storage in a garage or in another secondary room, that's on the wish list of all CHP users, also in the industry, because it makes you flexible. It's true, the production of thermal energy and electrical energy on the same time, it brings you a challenge to match the demand to the one or the other if these demands are on different times. Now, with this solution that is solved, we have the battery and we have also the thermal storage, which is the whole garage itself with all the stuff that's inside.
Okay, shit. A bit of person, eh?
By combining the heat pump and a generator in this way, you are solving three problems. First, you improve really very much the efficiency of the heat pump because the external unit is not anymore outside. Second, you recover the heat of the generator, making the entire system three times more effective and sustainable. And third, we resolved the problem of the difference between the demand for heat and for power. Because heat you may need at another time than the power, and the power we store into the battery, and the heat we store in our garage and all the stuff that's inside. By the way, the heat pump and the generator have also another thing in common. If you look to the generator, you have this proportion of electrical power and heat, which is 1 to 2. If you look now to the heat pump, then you have also a proportion between the electrical input and the heat output, which is then 2 or more in our case. So that creates also a kind of compatibility. This setup is a game changer for everyone that wants to make a do-it-yourself micro CHP. But at the same time, this is also an ideal solution in the case of a blackout, even if it takes 2 weeks. With a bit of frugality, you can live with 20 liters of gasoline for one whole week in a household. That is like a trip of 400 kilometers in a modern car. And with 5 liters a week, you have enough electricity for the fridge, for the computer and for some lights. And if it's cold, you can switch the fridge off and put all your stuff, your food stuff, on the balcony. However, you are making two products. You are making electricity and also power. So maybe the electricity is enough, but you have also to take into account that with 5 liters of gasoline a week, you have also less heat. So take that into account. Next week, you will see that I will install a normal mainstream split heat pump. I was first thinking about a swimming pool heat pump, because then in that case you will send warm water to the pipes which go into the living room. That's just simpler than having to couple two systems which work with refrigerants. And indeed, when I was looking to the prices of the mainstream heat pumps and swimming pool heat pumps, there was a price difference from 270 euros for the heat pump. Even a small water swimming pool heat pump is already over 500 euros. On the second hand market for swimming pool heat pumps, there were only bigger heat pumps, so they were second hand, they were also over 500 euros. So I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, to subscribe, and the next week we will see how the experiment goes on, and I hope to be able to install all these things which I bought yesterday. Let's build a resilient future together. I wish you good energy.